What's real? What's real? It's your boy Wayne Willie. You already know I'm in the bill, ready to get ill. So here's the dog on deal, people. If you hadn't hit that subscribe button, go ahead and smack that thing. And don't forget the notification bell, because you don't want to miss what we got going on. People, almost every week, we choose us a song, we learn that song, and then on Thursday, which is today, we open up the doors to the corner at 6 o'clock, and we try to give y'all one of the greatest renditions of that song that you ever heard. Even though it don't always go as planned, we put our best foot forward and we try to give y'all that great rendition. But people, we won't be doing that today because, first of all, like I told y'all on Monday, I got to rest my voice. And I've been working on singles, working on an album, working on a whole lot of other stuff. Got holidays coming up, Halloween, Christmas, might even throw a Thanksgiving joint in there. I don't know how you make a Thanksgiving song, but we're going to figure it out. Hey, because that's what we do. But anyway, people, let's get on down to business today. Today we are listening to, we are doing a continuation of listening to Marvin Gaye's 1978 album, Hear My Dear. The album dedicated to his ex-wife, Ann Gordy, who is Anna Gordy, but I'm going to keep saying Ann Gordy because it's easier for me because I got a speech impediment and a lisp and stuff like that and all that extra A at the end. I don't know. It's just excuses, people. But anyway, Ann Gordy, Marvin Gaye, got divorced in 1977, went to court. The court said, hey, you don't want to pay her money? Since you a great big American artist, how about you go in the studio and you make a project and you give all the proceeds to her? So out of that, Marvin Gaye went to the studio and he came up with the project, Hear My Dear. And basically what he means is, hear my dear, this is what you asked for, so this is what you get. So we are on track number three. We listen to the title track, which is number one, Hear My Dear. We listen to number two, I Met a Little Girl, which was a good one, which is so far my favorite. But today we're going to listen to track number three, which I feel, based on the title, is probably the most reflective track here. It's one of those tracks where he looked at the situation and he wondered, where did it go wrong? The title of this track is, When Did You Stop Loving Me, comma, When Did I Stop Loving You? So, like I said, based on that title, I feel like this is a reflection track. Now, this track is about 6 minutes long, I think. So we're going to be here for a minute. But yo, we're going to get down to the nitty gritty. We're going to listen to this song. And like I said on Monday, we won't be rating these songs because I want to wait till the album is complete to put a full rating on the album. And we'll talk about it in discussion there. But over the next few weeks, we're going to try to, and I just read a little bit more here. This is an instrumental. Yo, people, I want y'all to know that the version of this album that I'm listening to is from Apple Music. So it may be a little bit different than the copies y'all had, maybe from Amazon, maybe from whatever else, maybe the vinyl. Maybe y'all got the vinyl and y'all following there. But I want y'all to know that I am going off the exact track list. I'm going off, the first one was Hear My Dear, the title track. The second one was I Met a Little Girl. And this one is When Did You Stop Loving Me? When Did I Stop Loving You? The instrumental. However, there is another copy of this song on this album, so I will be listening to that later. I don't know when I'm going to get to it, but we'll definitely listen to that one. So don't take me out the door yet. But I am going in order, and I want y'all to know that 100%. So just to cover all the bases, have it soon.
I'm going through the
track list one by one. So We just gonna listen. Like I said, won't be doing ratings because, you know, that's crazy. We got a bunch of songs to listen to. We got 14 songs on this whole album. So we're gonna listen one by one, try to get it done as quickly as possible. Might be back in the corner next week. I don't know, but I'm definitely gonna get back in there because I wanna bring y'all some new material. And I got some requests that I wanna knock out too. So yeah, but let's hop into When Did You Stop Loving Me and When Did I Stop Loving You? Let's roll with it.
When did you stop loving me? When did I stop loving you? When did you stop loving me? When did I stop loving you?
This one right here is kind of groovy already. Sort of feeling about this one the way I felt about the first one.
Baby. Woo!
So I'm assuming that this is, you know, it's probably not completely an instrumental, but it does say instrumental. So we're gonna listen to it anyway, though. So far, it's a jam. Which I hate to talk through the song, but I feel like this is one of those songs where they say, where he said, y'all said make an album. I don't gotta sing on every song, but it's kind of, so far it's just like ad libs. When did you stop loving me? So it's given Marvin Gaye, of course.
I love you.
Yeah, that's kind of groovy.
And you said you love me too.
I know it's completely crazy to sit here and listen to this song, because it is an instrumental basically, but and I think my gimbal is dying. I don't know what's happening. Keep going till it dies, though.
I always remember you and all the fun we had.
There are some ad-libs in there, just about him reminiscing or whatever. Just him saying a little commentary here and there.
When did I stop loving?
As I'm listening, once again, it's an instrumental at this part, but it's not really instrumental because he is singing. It's just not many lyrics. It's kind of just like an ad-lib song, like I said once again, but I think it fits. You know, I think it fits between, you know, right after I met a little girl, that I think it flows well. I don't know what's next, because I never listened to the album before, but good placement is what I'm thinking. Definitely a groove, though. I will say that. Definitely a nice little jam. Maybe something like if you was going through a heartbreak or something, and you was going to the gym trying to get your swole on. This would definitely be a good one to keep on repeat as you're trying to get your swole on. You know what I'm talking about? Because it's got a steady pace, got a little groove to it. Maybe if you ain't going through a heartbreak, maybe you talking to your body. Talking to your body. When did you, you know what I'm talking about? That's definitely smooth right there. A lot of saxophone. Saxophone is one thing that I always like to incorporate. But I can never get it right, so. Motown cowbells, I can hear that.
When did you stop loving me? When did I stop loving you? When did you stop loving me? When did I stop loving you?
I'm not mistaken, it wasn't until halfway through where he started asking, when did I stop loving you? After when did you stop loving me? I think. So I don't know, there's some sort of meaning there. I like that one. That's a real good one. Like I said, it wasn't instrumental. It had a lot going on, but at the same time, it was a great, you know, a great interlude piece. It wasn't in a good position to be an interlude, but it's a good interlude piece. I like that. Gives me ideas for some of my projects. You know, if I don't have a lot of lyrics or something, but I got a smooth instrumental, just ad lib that thing and throw it on the. Hey, I don't know, but yeah, that's a good one. That's so far my second favorite. Only listened to three of them. Because I don't want to use a strong word like hate or despise, but the title track, Hear My Dear, like I said, Buddy was, I ain't going to tell nobody though. But hey, people, I got some stuff to do today. I got to make some runs. I got to get back in here and record some songs. But that was When Did You Stop Loving Me? When Did I Stop Loving You? The instrumental. But we listened to it, had a good time listening to it, and yeah, I thought it was a good one. But look, people, I don't know. I got stuff to do. It was good to see y'all today. I'm going to catch y'all. Today is Thursday, so I'm going to catch y'all Monday, and we're going to jump on to track number three, which is, I think this is right, A Funky Space Reincarnation. Hey, it's something for the books, I guess. A Funky Space Reincarnation. I'm going to catch y'all Monday at 5 p.m. I think sometimes I have problems uploading, but anyway, if you hadn't hit that like button, go ahead and hit it. If you hadn't hit that subscribe button, please don't forget it. I'm going to catch y'all when I catch y'all. I holla.